Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. MashaAllah, my beloved children. Today I want to tell you something very interesting. So the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, was born in Makkah al-Mukarramah. He was known as an honest, trustworthy person. He never lied. He never cheated anyone as he grew up. And at the age of 40, Allah Almighty made him a prophet and a messenger. Sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah told him to remind his people and to remind everyone not to do bad things, to do good things only, and not to worship anyone or anything besides the maker who made us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no one else. So a lot of people at that time rejected or did not want to listen to what he had to say. He gathered the people of Mecca, and they were on one side of the Mount Safa. You know, when you go to Mecca, you see Safa and Marwa. So behind Mount Safa, he gathered them and he stood on the mountain and he said, "O people of Mecca, if I were to tell you that there is an enemy behind me who is going to come and attack you, would you believe me?" They said, "Yes, we would believe you because you're a truthful person." So he says, so he told them, "I am warning you of a punishment that would come to you if you do bad things, if you don't worship Allah alone, etc., etc." And then they said, "No, we reject it, and you're a liar, and whatever else. So this is something that we must learn from." You know, many people don't like it when you tell them what's right, when you tell them not to do bad things. They don't like it. Sometimes even children don't like it when their parents tell them not to do bad things. You know, don't waste time, don't cheat, don't steal, don't deceive, meaning don't hurt people, don't tell a lie. You must pray. You must go to sleep at a certain time. Obviously, these are smaller things, but still people don't like to be told. We must learn from the people of Mecca that we should not be like that. We should be people who appreciate, we like it when someone tells us, "Don't do this because it's wrong." And then we should change so that we can grow and become successful people, inshallah. Now, what happened is they started harming him after that. They didn't like him. They started attacking and hurting some of his companions who believed in him and who started following him and who started doing the right thing. So when you do the right thing, when you dress nicely, properly, correctly, when you want to pray five times a day, when you are a good Muslim, for example, maybe people might not like you. Because from the beginning, they started attacking the Muslims and they started taking away their things and saying bad things about them. It can happen. Allah tells them, "Don't worry. I will give you victory. I will give you guidance. And I love you, and I'm going to make sure that in the end, you're going to succeed." So subhanallah, one day the Muslims had to leave Makkah al-Mukarramah because they were being hurt and attacked. And they went to Medina. They went to Medina Munawwara. They were being hurt in Makkah. They were being attacked. Their property was taken. Their money and wealth was taken. And a lot of their belongings were also taken. So when they got to Makkah al-Mukarramah, when they got to Medina from Makkah, they had a better place. People respected them. They loved them. And that's why Medina Munawwara is a beautiful place. It's the place where the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam and his companions had made the hijrah. You know, they traveled from Mecca to Medina. They left there everything and they went away. Now, Allah told them 2 years later that you can go back and, you know, these people stole your property. They hurt you. They took your belongings and everything. You can go back and you can fight them until you get everything back. Because it's your place. It's your land. It's your birthplace. It's your city, it's your property, your belongings. They had no right to take it. So the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, gathered 313 men. And subhanallah, he heard that there is a caravan coming from Syria, from Asham, back to Medina, back to Mecca, not far off from Medina. And Abu Sufyan was the head of that caravan. Abu Sufyan was one of the people of Makkah al-Mukarramah. He was not a Muslim at the time. And what happened is they had a lot of their belongings in what was known as a caravan of camels. They had a lot of their belongings. which were taken from the Muslims. They were doing business, they were coming back with goods and everything which was bought, which were bought by or with the money that they had taken away from the Muslims. So the Muslims, the 313 men, they were told by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala through the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him, to go and attack that caravan and take their property because it was theirs anyway. So as they left Medina, subhanallah, those people in the caravan got to hear that the Muslims are coming for us. And the Muslims had just gone for a small caravan of a few men. And the Muslims were 313. So that caravan decided to use a different path to go to Makkah so that the Muslims would just follow, until they ended up not too far off from Makkah in a place known as Badr. Badr is closer to Makkah than Medina. And subhanallah, when they got to Badr, the people of Makkah, the non-Muslims or the disbelievers of Makkah, had brought in an army of 1,000 men. And they said, now we're going to swipe these Muslims and we're going to finish them up. But the Muslims, subhanallah, they spent the night in worship calling out to Allah, while these people of Mecca actually spent the night drinking and dancing and partying. So when they got up in the morning, the war was about to take place. 313 Muslims and 1,000 of the people of Mecca. And what happened is, these people got up in the morning, they were semi-dizzy, they had just had a night of partying and so on. Some of them might have been partly drunk as well. And the Muslims, the war began, and they won. They won the battle in a very short time. That was the Battle of Badr. Now, it took place in Ramadan on a day like this. So, on the 17th of Ramadan, that's when this Battle of Badr took place. I explained to you why it took place. The Muslims were trying to get back their property, their wealth, their dignity, their homeland, and so on. So this was the first of the major wars that took place between the people of Mecca and the Muslims. And subhanallah, they won because they were steadfast, they were praying all night, they tried very hard, they listened to the instruction of Allah, they heard and listened to the instruction of the Prophet Muhammad, peace be upon him. They achieved great successes, mashallah. Now, we must pray to Allah that Allah grant us also success. Right now, we have so much going on across the globe. If you follow Allah and you follow the instruction of the Messenger Muhammad, peace be upon him, and you're a good person, you try to pray and you try to stay away from drinking and partying and whatever else might harm you. The intoxicants. Intoxicants means things that make you drunk, the drugs, whatever else it may be. We stay away from all those things because we're Muslims, and Muslims are not allowed to do that, subhanallah. So if we stay away from all of that, we will get victory. You know, at the beginning, the Muslims thought, what's going to happen here? Because we're only 313 in number. These people of Makkah are 1,000. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calmed them down. He sent angels to protect them. He sent angels to fight on their behalf. And guess what? They won the war. The Battle of Badr was won by the Muslims. That's an amazing thing. So if someone were to ask you, when did the Battle of Badr take place? You say, 17th of Ramadan, second year of Hijrah. MashaAllah. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect every one of us. And I'm so glad to have shared this with you. Let's pray for the whole Ummah and humanity at large. May Allah protect us all from the coronavirus and from all other diseases and sicknesses. May Allah eradicate and get rid of all of that for us. Ameen. Jazakumullah khair. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.